Hey, good morning, Janice and Mike. Right behind me, that Hampton Inn that you were mentioning, right off of I-65 Walker Chapel Road. And you can see behind me some of the damage left by that storm earlier this morning. Part of that sign for the Hampton Inn ripped off, but even more so, the roofing and some of the siding coming off as well, part of the insulation. And it was ripped off to the point where you could actually see inside of some of those rooms there. So definitely a lot of damage. When we first got out here on the scene, there were actually a few people trying to see if they could move some of the damage that had gotten onto the top of their cars, because there were still cars parked in the lot right beside the hotel, and just a lot of damage caused by that. And if we come around here, some of the other damage was to the power in the area, power lines down throughout the area, and even throughout the exit here right off of Walker Chapel Road on Highway 65. Now, crews have finally sort of gotten the traffic flowing a little bit better here, but when we first got out here, they were still trying to manage that, sort of trying to direct traffic, and that's what they're trying to do now a little bit more efficiently, thankfully, because of the fact that some of these traffic lights had went out here. So police are out here. Alabama Power is also out here on the scene. And we also want to swing around and show you just how much of this power is out. It extends to what over here is normally a Chick-fil-A, an Arby's, and a McDonald's. Right now, all of that power is out, so you can't see any of that. All you can see right now is the light from the vehicles that are going across here, and that's because of all of the power in this area being out. We're still working to find out when that power can be back up. Around close to 7,000 people in Jefferson County are without power right now, and we're still finding out more details about those search and rescue efforts, as well as the multiple people who were injured during this. Now, we do know that there are also some more possible fatalities. We haven't had more of those confirmed yet, but we do have that one confirmed in Jefferson County, unfortunately. So we're learning more details, and we'll continue to keep you updated throughout the day as we learn more. Johnathan Skinner, WBRC Fox 6 News on your side, reporting from Fultondale, and we'll toss it off to Claire at the First Alert desk now.
All right, everybody, you're hearing about this breaking news there. Fox has just reported one person is confirmed dead and several injured after the tornado in Alabama. We have a different vantage point right here. This is actually a different county, matter of fact. I want to make sure I get the right one for you. This is Jackson County, Alabama, so not too far away. But again, we're hearing there could be more than one fatality, one death as a result of this tornado. And we just heard from a reporter out there on the scene. You saw the Hampton Inn Hotel behind him. He was saying that people staying at the hotel were trying to remove debris from their cars. I do not know what sort of business this is or if it's a home. I've been keeping a very close eye on these live images here for at least about a half hour here. There is no reporter on this scene that I've seen so far. I've had the audio up. I've been listening in, and very few details here, but you just see this mangled mess. Now, remember, the National Weather Service needs to send people out all the time for severe storm damage to confirm that it is, in fact, a tornado, and then they need to rate it based on the wind speeds and the destruction and the path that the storm has left behind. So again, we are likely going to be keeping a very close eye on this all day here on News Now from Fox and provide you any updates as they become available. But again, people in Alabama waking up to severe storm damage, and unfortunately we're learning of deaths, possibly one confirmed so far, as well as injuries as a result of the storm that moved through. So again, we're going to continue to keep a very close eye on it for you and provide you any updates here on News Now from Fox. Meanwhile, everybody, good morning. My name is Pilar Arias. I'm coming at you live from the News Now from Fox East Coast Hub right here in Orlando.